guys, karibuni Mom Nation, welcome back. The gang is here. Today we want to discuss about postpartum, what you went through when you are a new mom, a second time mom, a third time mom. I mean, we are moms. So I want to welcome the group, but before I welcome them, let me start with my own experience. So yeah, we are 3 months now. For me is, let me start on a positive note, the bonding, yeah? The bonding is great for both my first and second. I mean, just holding the baby, feeling the warmth, them growing, you know, the love and all that, that is really nice. So guys, karibuni, what has your experience been like on postpartum?
For me, like for my firstborn, I feel like I was an emotional wreck. Mm-hmm. Because it was not, I like familiarity, and this was something I had never done. Mm-hmm. And then what happened? My husband works out of town. So after his paternity leave, he was out of town. He was working in shifts. So, and my baby had colic. Yeah. I used to cry. My nights were horrible. I used to cry. So much. Mm-hmm. Because I used to look at the time, like 7 o'clock reaches, and I'm just seeing the clock is going 8, 9, and at 10, mm-hmm. the colic strikes until 1 a.m. I used to cry. And wow. it's so emotionally draining. And I had read on baby center, whatever happens to your baby, whatever happens if your baby is crying, don't shake them, so you'll give them brain damage. But I had that urge to shake the baby. So I remember even one day I left, I just put him in the bed and I went to the sitting room and I just left him there crying. And I, apparently initially I didn't know it's colic. Mm-hmm. So by the time I learned that it's colic, you know, after you go for your 2 weeks clinic, then it's when the doctor tells you, that's, you describe what it is and they tell you it's colic. Then I was like, oh my goodness. No wonder it happens at certain times. Yeah. Then now I understood Kumbe is even in pain. Because mm-hmm. at first I thought he's just crying. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But it was, emotionally it was so bad. Yeah. The second and the third have been good. I prayed that colic away. But then I said, anything but colic. I had other issues. Like for the second born, because me, I'm a CS mom. As yes, ma'am. Mm. Did I call myself a CS?
Did you call yourself a CS? Baby, I was like,
What is that? You branded yourself. What is a CS, ma'am?
You are a mom.
My babies, I've had them through CS. So, the second born, that was the most painful mm-hmm. experience, and the recovery was very, very hard. Mm. But at least emotionally, I was better. And the mm-hmm. the baby didn't have colic, but also I was wiser,
yeah.
So I knew what I need to eat, what I shouldn't eat, mm-hmm. and all that stuff. So I remember one day he was what do you call when they become yellow in the eyes?
Jaundice.
Yeah, he was jaundiced. Yeah. So was sitting in the sun. Then I saw him cringing his stomach. I was like, hey, what did I eat yesterday for lunch, for dinner, and what did I have for breakfast? Whatever it was, I saw it was some medicine I'd taken. I think those. The things for breastfeeding, pregnant care breastfeeding, mm-hmm. I stopped it immediately, you know. So I was very, very deliberate about it. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
also remember for me, our second born,
yes, she was crying and crying and crying. And I was telling my husband, Yanni, those ones of he's held that baby, he's going to work the next day, mm-hmm. he's held that baby the whole night. Mm-hmm. The mosque starts calling. You're like, fine. It's morning. The birds are singing.
This
baby,
slept.
We've not slept.
Yeah.
We're still holding the baby. But I remember we went, this is a 24-hour pharmacy. I told him, go and get that dawa for colic. Mm. And we gave it to her. And within minutes, mm-hmm. she just calmed down and she fell asleep.
Mm. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
But you see, one thing I've been told about colic is the way you bap the baby after feeding.
Mm.
So for me, I think I knew it because of my support system. Like, just wait for him until he baps very well. Even if you'll hold him for like 30 minutes, but they'll sleep peacefully.
Have you tried bapping at 1 a.m.?
Yes,
and you're like,
I do that. Yes, but it makes a difference. Once you put him down, they sleep.
Yeah.
They really do. Okay, so maybe let's talk about now the healing process after the hospital, after you come from the hospital. Of course, we give birth. We're all moms. Mm. it's hard, whether you went through CS or normal delivery. Yeah. Kudos, guys, moms, men, you're doing a good job. But that healing process, for normal delivery, for me it was sitting in the in the salt water, ndani ya beseni, you go all the way down and you sit on it.
It relaxes.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't stay.
No, it doesn't. Maybe you can give us your experience.
I mean, just answering her, yeah. It relaxes. It's very calming. And then for me, I combined it with me time. You know, when you tell people in your house that you need to go and they leave you alone.
Unless the baby cries.
Yeah. I don't know. I had a bad experience with my guy now. I don't know. I think they were trying out a new healing process. Oh, no. So they didn't insist on the salt bath. Mm-hmm. So they insisted on cleaning with cotton wool and water.
Wow.
You guy, I was in
hospital. Cotton wool and water.
Imagine.
Like, is this for your firstborn?
Yeah, firstborn. Really? In fact, I remember I went to her office. I was furious.
Yeah, you're a new mom.
And that's why second baby, I just went straight to the midwives. Because now when I went back to hospital, they were like, there's no shortcut with that.
There's no.
So I'm telling them what I was told by the doctor. Mm-hmm. And they're like, no.
No.
You can get better by sitting on them.
And you get better really fast.
Yeah. It's not painful.
It's not painful.
And then it's cleaning. You feel clean.
No, you can go down. You can go down and reach there.
What are your options, really?
You don't have an option.
What are your options?
You hold the door.
You know, for us, and I think that's why we're finding it hard.
Yes.
CS, there are stitches over here.
Yes.
Yeah.
There is a cut over here.
Yeah.
With a huge bandage.
Even going to the toilet, you are like, even
walking.
The same way like a do you call it natural? I don't know. The same way if you had a vaginal birth, you don't have a problem with gas and doing a number two and da-da-da-da. It's the same way. Like, it's very different. Yeah. Like, we don't have gas issues unless you eat something bad.
Yeah.
Wow. Doing number two is part of the process. Like, you don't, at least for me, it was like that. Like, it wasn't, you know, there he has, yes, ma'am, like, hey, okay.
Yeah.
You know, I'm sorry for the pain.
Tell us, Shiro.
No, my healing, my healing for both was, you feel like there's a part of, when you wake up, you feel like a part of you is not there. Like, it's a cut.
Mm.
And so, you feel like, I don't know, it's an out of body. I felt it was like numbish. And then you're told to be very careful about how, you know, you can't lift heavy things. Mm-hmm. Going up the stairs is hard. I live in a maisonette.
Mm-hmm.
So I moved upstairs and I stayed there. I did not come down for like a week or so. Oh. But but it was okay. Like, the healing, of course, you're told to walk a lot.
Yeah.
So that you don't get clots and stuff. But it's very difficult. And even when I hear about salt bath, you know, when I cut myself and I put salt, unawashwa.
Yes.
So sir.
Okay.
It's not the same. This place
it's
is moist 24/7. So it's different from like a normal hand cut.
It's nice warm water, a little salt.
Okay.
Yeah.
You sit. Actually, you feel really nice.
It's actually relaxing. Like,
yeah, to experience this.
Me, I remember my second born. The healing after my second born was the worst. Because they cut, the same place.
The same place.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Same place.
Yes.
Same
place. And I think I remember asking the doctor, so where are you going to cut this time? So it's like the same place.
Mm.
Then I think I didn't believe him. I was like, whatever.
Like, that's
cutting
a muscle twice.
Yes. It's the same scar they cut.
Yeah, because it's already weak.
How many will they cut? So if you have 4 CSs, how many will they cut? How many scars will you have?
Yeah.
So they cut that same place. And they cut. And I think I gave birth at around noon. At around 6, the morphine wore off. My friend. Hey. I don't know. But I'm like asking. I call the nurses like, I think 10 times.
Pain.
Yeah. Pain. But you see, they can only give you
so much.
They will not give you the morphine until the doctor prescribes. Then, okay, we are calling the doctor. Then they call the doctor. Then the doctor has prescribed. Then they take another 2 hours to bring the morphine. I was in pain. I nearly went mad. Then some nurse says, I'm bringing the baby. I told her, wait. Stay with that baby. If you bring that baby here, I'll throw him back at you. So they had to sleep with the baby. And then so they gave me the morphine. Then later, like after 2 hours, mm-hmm. the nurse came and she said, you need to susu. I'm like, no, I don't need to susu. I don't need to susu. I don't feel like susuing. She said, your bladder is full. You need to susu. Yeah. I'm like, how do you, I'm the one. Yeah. It's my bladder. Yeah. So she's like, you need to susu. Yeah. She's like, I'm bringing a bedpan. You need to susu. I was like, okay. So she, me, I was sure I don't need to susu.
You peed for like 15 minutes.
Yes, yeah. I peed for like 15 yeah. minutes. Yeah. And then in like later on, like after 4 hours, then I said, now I wanted to susu. Yeah. So I called. She's like, now you need to go to the toilet. I told her I can't. Mm, I told her very calmly, I can't. Much. She told me, you have to go.
You need to walk.
They make you walk. Even the susuing, because she told me, I'm not bringing the bedpan to the bed. I'm going to put it on this chair. You have to come out of the bed and pee. Mm. And I was like, from here to this stool, hey, that's like a marathon. So it took like an hour, 15 minutes to get me to sit there. Mm-hmm. Now she's telling me I have to walk out to the toilet. I was like, imagine, it's not possible.
It's not possible.
And she said, you have to. So we just struggled. It was the most painful thing I've ever felt. And she's not helping me.
Nah.
She's just standing there.
Like making sure
yeah, she's not holding me. Like, I'm sick, surely.
Oh, no, you.
You're not sick.
No.
You've had that.
Yeah, but I have had a cut. I'm sick.
You need to get
yeah, I know. But I'm like, you hold me. Naturally, mm-hmm. even yeah. if you are with me, you would hold me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm expecting her to hold me. She's not holding me. But she just comes. She's just walking with me. And she comes to the toilet with you. She's like, and she'll be there. In case I collapse, she'll be there. But she's not holding me.
That's her holding you. Yeah.
By the next morning, I could go take a shower.
Yeah.
In fact, I told her, thank you very much.
You're allowed to shower the same day. Like you shower.
The next day.
Yeah.
Oh, and then? Like with water running down?
Yes.
The bandage is waterproof.
Yeah.
So you can shower.
Oh, yeah.
You can shower.
But even that shower. There's a time people never used to shower after years. That's probably a new.
I think more
whatever.
Different doctors do it differently.
And technology.
Technology has evolved.
And then, guys, the pressure. I mean, for all guys watching, mothers, the pressure, you're in that pain and you're supposed to breastfeed and hold that baby. Mm. What are we made of? I mean.
Yeah.
Maybe we can talk about the pressure on Gary. This motherhood thing, yeah?
First of all, big up to all moms. We are super moms. Why lie? Because, I mean, there's so much. Yeah, the pressure is a lot. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of expectation. You're like, okay, so you've just given birth. Everybody gives birth. Everybody breastfeeds. So you just move. I mean, you just take it as it comes. Mm-hmm. Just one at a time. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that thing of having a cat, then you have to hold the baby. Mm-hmm. Then you have to. Then, You're bleeding.
For 6 weeks.
And then even that thing of sharing.
And then you're given another thing that they don't, we are not going to give you too much detail. But you're given something without wings.
Yeah.
And
we
hold it.
Guys, That is coming up.
Watch out for that Thunder 1 and Thunder 2.
I was going to say
pressure. That thing of showering.
Yeah.
You told, okay, you can shower, but mm-hmm. now, okay, mm-hmm. so you have to wash your feet. Okay, mm-hmm. how am I getting down there?
Down there.
You know, it's such a
You don't
task.
Have to wash your feet.
By the way, you don't. You realize later on, by the way, it's not a must. The water just calms you down and makes you feel sane. You're like, okay, I'm done. And then that's the only me time before they give you the baby back.
Okay. I think the other part of healing that was a shocker mm-hmm. was when you start breastfeeding, your stomach cramps in another out of this world experience. I was like, what is happening? Like the pain. Yes. And then, you know, the nurse now tells you now your stomach
is contracting
and the breastfeeding helps to contract for the healing.
Woo! Okay.
I used to dread breastfeeding the first few times. Mm. I think it went away in like 2-3 days, so it was good. Yeah.
Okay. Maybe to go back to emotions. Mm-hmm. I think postpartum for me was like Eunice, I was a mess. Like there were so many things that you know, I'm an independent person. And so we all are when you're adults. But, you know, I'm a very independent person. But then now there was this baby that needed to be with me all the time. I was the food. I was there. I was the one changing food. It. I was there.
Everything.
I was
you.
Everything.
Yeah.
And then I think I was not. Yeah. To be honest, I think I just ran the motions for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And here, because the child needs to either be washed, be fed, and nobody's giving you a break. Yeah.
Mm.
Then I went to my mom-in-law's, and I mean, it was a good break for sure, because, you know, they were they were feeding you everything. But still, I honestly felt that there's something that has misaligned within my whole being. Because there's a lot that I want to talk about. Now your mother-in-law is there with you. You're just like, now you can't understand. Mm-hmm. She's had six babies.
I know.
Me, I'm on my first. And then I'm just feeling like I'm so overwhelmed. She's like, you're doing well. And I'm like,
It doesn't feel like
you're doing well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. I don't know.
Okay. And I know we have support systems, sisters, mother-in-laws, husbands, and
those
all.
Those are very important.
Yes.
Me, I don't have sisters.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That being overwhelmed is
it's
crazy. Yeah. Yeah, okay. It's crazy. And you see, men can't give it the same way.
Yes.
Yeah, like a fellow woman can.
Feeling.
Yeah, so even if you go to visit.
Don't know what you're
yeah,
doing.
If you visit a close new mom, mm-hmm. help as much as you can.
Yeah,
and even moms, we should be able to accept the help.
Yes.
We should be able willing to accept the help.
Yeah,
it's very important.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. But I'm just thinking of it in terms of there are visitors that come. Of course, there's a support system, your close people. Then the visitors start coming. So where do we draw the line so that these visitors are not bogging down our emotions, putting on a lot of pressure on us? When do you say no? When do you say yes? Because there's also loneliness. I mean, you're also lonely. There's a newborn here, so.
I think for me, like,
mm-hmm.
just to take it back a bit,
mm-hmm.
my firstborn, I was fine. I'm extroverted, yeah? So my firstborn, I was fine.
Mm-hmm.
I had everything.
Mm-hmm.
Where my emotions were wrecked was with my secondborn.
Mm-hmm.
And because apparently you're supposed to know how to do this thing,
mm-hmm.
you know, like,
mm-hmm.
it's your second time.
Second.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're a veteran. And I'm like, imagine I'm a veteran for being a first-time mom.
Mm-hmm. Not a second
I'm time. A newbie to being a second-time mom and being a mom to two children.
Mm-hmm.
And then, as you're saying, loneliness, you're asking about loneliness, like, because you're a veteran, because
mm-hmm.
people don't pay so much attention to second-time
mm-hmm.
moms vis-a-vis
mm-hmm.
first-time moms,
mm-hmm.
then you're on your own.
Mm-hmm.
Not really on your own, but you don't have as much support or as much doting over you as you did with your firstborn.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think I just learned to ask for help.
I learned to, and my
help for me was not even come and wash or come and
mm-mm.
do stuff. My help was come stay with the baby. I read a book. Come
mm-hmm.
stay with the baby. I binge watch Scandal. Like, you know, like
yeah.
when the baby is
or I sleep
or okay, maybe not sleep for me, or I take a walk
mm-hmm.
or something, you know.
Okay.
So I think at some point as a mom, you must be very intentional
mm-hmm.
to also ask for the help. Like,
yes.
go out and get the help. Tell your guys what you're going through. It's new. I'm sure even for a third time,
mm-hmm.
it's still new because
mm-hmm.
it's a whole new
it's
human
whole
being.
New
being.
With
yeah.
an and you have the older
with
ones.
An addition to
yeah.
two more.
Yeah.
Okay.
Who, yeah.
But also, I found that after delivering, I used to take a walk around
mm-hmm.
the estate.
Mm-hmm.
Just so that you're seeing, okay, life is going on, imagine, and you want to experience the birds. You know, just want to step out of
mm-hmm.
your environment.
Yeah.
For 10 minutes and then go back to it.
Yeah.
So that now you can handle this baby and whatever
okay.
pressures that come with it. Yeah,
so
that
remember
helps.
Guys, it's so easy to get into postpartum depression. It creeps in pole.
Mm-hmm.
And me, I understood why most women after giving birth, it's very easy kuchapa. Eh? Kuchapa. Eh? Like your hair, your... yani ume beat. When I gave birth,
yes.
I understood why
mm-hmm.
it's very easy to beat. And you have to be very deliberate about, you know, being back, coming back to yourself. Yeah, so let us know what's your experience, your postpartum experience, yeah? Like, share, subscribe this episode and comment below. Tell us what you think. And remember, ask for help, eh?
Yeah.
reach out for help.